Welcome back to Let's Play A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, heading back to the monastery. Get the name. Panequia Monastery. So hopefully this time, convince someone whose name is Avarice to stop being full of avarice. Attack! I'm not going to use our finishing moves. Still going to be a slaughter. Oh, Miles getting close and even to level 14. I don't think I'm gonna make it fighting these creatures, though. Actually damaged her. That'll teach ya. Yeah, we're hardly getting any XP from these things. I do not want that. We're back. Avon says, anyway, I have to tell Great Oracle about this incident. We need to make him stop me for hunting, no matter what. That greedy man, Douglas says. I don't expect him to listen to us so easily. I don't think the gods will punish me for saying something mean about that crook. I don't think so either. Oh. I don't want it. We're still throwing stuff all over and littering. There was an evil atmosphere floating around. What happened in the town? We're not gonna tell you. Oh, you came here to persuade Great Oracle Avarice. We also heard about Mipha hunting and were very concerned. Please, take care of the issue on behalf of us. We'll check in here. Oh, Mr. Avon, I thought you've already gone. Sister Oli? Did we talk to her before? Miss Olesia is upstairs. Yeah, we were gone, but we came back. We kind of come and go as we please, you know? When I climbed up the bell tower this morning to toll a bell, I saw a sky towards New Boron dark and cloudy. I thought that was weird, so I reported Miss Olesia about it, but the cloud was gone before we knew. I wonder if that was my optical illusion. Your optical illusion? When we clean this tower bell, we have to use a ladder. That thrills me. It thrills you? I'm waiting for you to find a potion that's useful. Great Oracle Avarice is basically a very religious person. He hasn't missed any services since he came here. He's probably confessing his sins because he knows he's a evil dude. But how come he's so attached to roses? Because his name's Avarice. Great Oracle Avarice interrupts our service whenever he finds a reason to. He's harassing our director, I think. Well, who's the director? Alessia? If it's not Alessia, then we haven't met the director, at least not yet. Great Oracle came here right after Amel left on her journey. She must be saddened if she saw the current situation of the monastery. You mean she would be saddened. I hope we'll be able to restore peace before Amel comes back. My grandmother lives in the capital. I haven't seen her for a while, but I always write to her. I can't write about the current situation of the monastery, though. Not too depressing. So talk to Alessia first. Oh, Avon, you haven't left New Boren yet? Yeah. There were some troubles we had to take care of. Avon explained to Alessia about the incident in New Boren. Bardis, I never thought it would come to this. Sister Sina says it must be Avarice's fault. If he didn't lift the ban of Mifa hunting, this wouldn't have happened. That's too much, Sina. But the people in the monastery are being leery of Great Oracle Avarice for sure. Now, I heard about the disaster in New Boren. I can't leave it alone anymore. We were thinking about going to meet Great Oracle, says Mile. I hope he'll wake up if we tell him about the disaster in New Boren. Avon says, I don't think he will listen to us meekly, though. But I'll try to talk him out first. You could be right, Alessia says. Please tell Great Oracle Avarice what you saw. If he still doesn't change his mind, I have to think of something. I think Great Oracle is in his room. You mean the director's cottage or building or whatever? Hey, Avon. I can help you if you want. Sina! What are you doing secretly there? Nothing. Alright. Yeah, I just talked to her. Oh. Cat's keeping us busy with garbage here. Oh. Alright. Got the Mr. Smiley Pants himself. Huh? Says Avon. Where did Avarice go? Where is he? Asks Mile. Oops. Was he sneaking up behind us? Oh, he's in there. New Boren is suffering from the evil spirit, huh? I didn't expect this to happen so soon. Well, that's okay. I'm going back to Valkt as soon as I hunt the rest of the Mithas. I'll gain support from aristocrats by bribing them with the Mifa fur and steal the position of Supreme Priest from Kroar. What a perfect plan. A voice says, do you think things will go that smoothly? Who's that? Oh, that's the Blue Bandana guy. Blue Bandana Man or whatever? He says, you haven't changed a bit. You brought disaster to New Boren, just like you did to Canafia. Where's Canafia? You will continue to screw people over as long as you live, huh? Maybe people who rely on the gods have a soft spot. Huh? Who are you? I'm a ghost of your past. 15 years ago, to be exact. What the? And a ghost's job is to torment. Prepare to die. Huh? Help! Someone! Avon says, isn't that Great Oracle Avarice's voice? We have to save this guy now? I'm preferring to more, like, help kill him. Where did it come from? Says Mile. Douglas says, it came from the next building, probably from the chapel. Archim says, I have a bad feeling. I'll give you time to repent your sins. You may be able to gain mercy from Bardas.
Wait! 15 years ago, I was abbot of Brazak. I don't have any recollection of any wrongdoing that might have occurred ill will on anyone.
Do you have any memory of a girl named Dominique?
Dominique.
I don't know anyone by that name. Just as I expected, you are the most low-down, evil person I've ever seen. I can send you to the Netherworld without regret.
Just wait! It's on the tip of my tongue!
You can run away if you want, but that just means you'll have to suffer longer. You can't escape my wrath.
No! I don't want to die!
Avon says, hey, what are you doing?
Oh, this must be a divine intervention from Bardas. Guys, please drive this murderer away.
The man says, we met right at the exit of New Boren. This man has to suffer for what he did. Don't interfere with my plan. Archim says, please wait. What did this man do to you?
You probably already know this, but he's responsible for causing the evil spirits in New Boren.
He has caused the same thing in many other places. I can no longer overlook it.
Avon says, that doesn't mean you can kill him.
Miles says, if he's responsible for these crimes, there are other ways to punish him, such as taking him to court.
If the gods won't punish him, then someone else has to.
If you interfere with my plan, you'll be guilty of letting an evil criminal go. Do you want that on your conscience?
Douglas says, hold on.
Let's settle this between you and me.
Douglas? Says Avon.
You look more skillful than that, kid. Your stance. Are you a disciple of the School of Castle? The Saint of the Sword?
Douglas asks, do you know my master?
I had a short time with him. The rumors were true. He was a tremendous swordsman.
But you haven't reached that his level yet.
The sword on your back will do you no good.
My master taught me that a sword is not for hurting others, but is used to let others live.
I carried out his teachings.
All right. Have it your way, but you will die.
I wouldn't be so cocky if I were you.
Alessia says, enough, Madrum!
Not that guy's name? Madrum? This is a chapel, a place of worship. I forbid you to shed blood here.
Alessia, Madrum says, it's been a while.
So, it's you, as I expected.
Why do you target Sir Avarice?
Are you asking why? You are asking why, even though you were Dominique's best friend?
There is no way you couldn't have known this, since you are part of the foundation of the church. This man killed Dominique.
He needs to be punished for it.
This would not make Dominique happy, Alessia says. Dominique was one of the kindest people I have ever known. If you get blood on your hands, she would be sad.
Ha ha ha. My hands have already been painted by blood. I can never be with Dominique again.
However, my feelings have changed for now. I'll be back to execute that man some other day.
Great Oracle Avarice, look forward to the day.
Poor man, Madrum, says Alessia.
Please protect me! He's gonna come back and kill me!
I don't wanna die!
Sir Avarice, Alessia says, pull yourself together.
There's a good reason for you to be a target.
Let me hear what you have done in detail.
Yeah, the music was driving me insane. I guess Sir Avarice has done many bad things in his past. One of them is permitting Mipha hunting again. He was going to send the Mipha fur to the aristocrats as a present.
Really?
Of course, bribery is prohibited by the church. He will need to be investigated at the Holy Capital. Miles says, I can't believe that the Great Oracle confessed everything. Sister Sina says, I bet that guy must have scared him a lot. I think he thought it would be better to be arrested than getting killed. Avon says, who the heck is Madrim? He looks like quite a swordsman. Douglas says, he's more than skilled. I don't know if I could have beaten him, even if I gave him all I've got. To be honest, I'm glad she stopped the fight. Madrim is an old friend of mine. Madrim, Dominique, and I entered the Bardas Church at the same time. He was trained under Sage Gawain, a counselor of the church. Avon says, Gawain? The same guy who took me to Grandpa Lamarissa's house? Douglas says, Sage of Power, Gawain is a warrior who is as good as my master. I can understand why Madrim is so skilled if he was trained under him. Archim says, how come Madrim attacked Great Oracle Avarice? 15 years ago, something awful happened. I won't tell you all the details. I will just tell you that Dominique died, and Madrim left the church. And it looks like Sir Avarice was involved in a tragedy somehow. Avon says, so he must have been involved in evil deeds repeatedly. Miles says, but hopefully the issue about Mipha hunting will be solved soon, since the Great Oracle's true purpose was discovered. Olesia says, I issued a prohibition against hunting Mifas again. I'm sure no one will hunt them anymore. People will be a little confused, I think. Archim, I'm sorry for what you had to go through. No, it's okay. Thank you very much. I know they are happy, too. Sister Sina says, Director, what do you... Oh, she is the director. Director, what are you going to do with Avarice? He can't stay here any longer. You're right. I'm thinking about asking the Adventurer Guild to send him under escort to the Holy Capital. Considering that Madrim is after him, it would be hard to send him safely without the help of a skilled adventurer. Says Avon. How about Douglas? Douglas says, what? You can protect the Great Oracle even if that guy shows up again. I think he is the most qualified for this task. Well, Douglas is with us. You can't go anywhere. I don't mind, but I promised that I would help you on your journey. I haven't repaid my debt on the Thunder Sword yet. Don't worry about that anymore. Now that I was able to find out Imel's whereabouts, I feel like I will be able to see her soon. I want you to do what only you can do. If you say so. I hate when these people leave. Douglas says, Director, is it alright if I take the responsibility to escort Avarice back? That would be great. Mr. Douglas, thank you for your service. Douglas says, well, it's time to say goodbye for now. Avon, Mile, Archim, thank you for everything. Avon says, thank you. We owe you one. Mile says, thanks for watching out for us. Archim says, be careful. Thanks. You are heading to Valk across the ocean after finding your sister, right? We may be able to see each other again if we are lucky. You guys are still growing. I'll expect you to be stronger the next time we meet. Avon says, yeah, you bet we will. Miles says, I hope that you will have the skill to handle your Thunder Sword soon. Yeah, me too. Well then, it's sad to say, but it's time to go.
He's dragging the Avarice guy away.
Avon says he's gone. It's time for us to go too. Miles says, we are going to continue on our quest to find Imel. Next stop will be Guia, the town of Ironworks. Archim says, Guia is north of Newborn, right? Then please let me go part of the way with you. Alright, you can come, says Avon. Let's go. Miss Alessia, we need to get going now. Avon, be careful. Sister Sina says, Avon, please rescue Imel. You can count on us. We will find and protect her. May Bardas be with you on your journey, says Alessia.
we talk to them again? Apparently we can.
Our monastery is safe now. Take off after Emel right away. I know she's waiting for you.
Take off, huh?
May Avon be safe throughout his journey. May Bartis protect him.
I didn't like Great Oracle, but I'm very glad that his life was spared. Murdering is an act that saddens Bartis the most.
Anyway, I can't believe someone who has trained so much could become like that. I wonder if a human is sinful no matter what.
Great Oracle Avarice was taken away, so finally this monastery would be able to return to normal.
But who in the world attacked him?
I forget his name already.
Blue Bandana Man.
That's who it is. Oh, they're not here anymore. Oops.
Please tell Amel this when you are reunited. Every one of us is worried about her. Finish what she has to do and come back right away.
Avon says, yeah, I'll for sure tell her. Thank you for caring about her.
Ah, but if she were reunited with you, Emel wouldn't come back to the monastery, right?
Then I would say goodbye with a big smile.
I don't think you should write about it in a letter to your grandmother. She's very religious, so she'll be shocked if she finds out Great Oracle was arrested.
I think it was you that was going to write it to grandmother, not us. So where did Alessia go?
Oh, she must be back in the director's office. That's right.
She was there because Avarice was hanging out in there. So we'll find her there again.
That Great Oracle was a complete imposter, just as I thought. Good work, Avon. Now the monastery will regain the peace we had before.
How come Great Oracle is gone?
Sarai said that he was punished by heaven. Did he do something bad?
Punished by heaven?
Oops. When you are reunited with Emel, please give her my best regards.
Avon, please be careful. I pray that you will be reunited with Emel soon. May Bartis protect you.
Okay. We're done in here.
The way out.
Bye.
I'm gonna throw something over here. There you go.
Now, they say even more new things now? Let me see.
Oh, it's a perfect timing. Everyone, please take this. They were given Fruit Witch.
So this was it, Avon says. Bread, fruit, and whipped cream. It looks very delicious, says Mile. They also loved it. I hope Mephas will visit us again.
Is it a potion?
Yeah. Special sandwich with soft whipped cream and seasonal fruits. I wonder what that does. We don't need a rest. She's still over here, sleeping. Avon, says Mile.
What?
Let's leave while Shannon is asleep. We're in the middle of a dangerous journey. We can't get Shannon involved. She has nothing to do with it. I can't put her at risk.
Mile?
Mile, no matter how serious you make it sound, I know. You just want to get away from Shannon. Avon, please. Let's get going before Shannon wakes up. Hurry.
That is funny.
I'm curious about what you'll say next, says Avon.
Maybe we should stay the night. She might wake up and visit us.
I'll reform my bad behavior and return to my old job. I was a laborer at the unloading dock there. Oh man, what should I do now that I can't hunt Mephas? Is there any easy job that makes a lot of money? You could work with Gratz here.
Well, he's right there talking, you can hear him.
Douglas is so upright. He thanked me and paid up all the tabs. He said he was going to go to the Holy Capital. I want him to come back to New Boren again. A disaster will befall those who antagonized a sweet-smelling animal. I knew it. We shouldn't have ignored the prophecy. Our ancestors had such great wisdom. Douglas asked me to look after New Boren while he was gone. I don't know if I can do this job.
You should be more confident, says Avon.
Miles says Douglas is an honest man. I'm sure he really trusts you.
You think so?
I'm encouraged. I'll improve my skills as much as possible while Douglas is gone. He'll be surprised to see my improvements when he comes back. I feel a flaming passion welling up inside me.
Not sure if Douglas is interested in that part.
Avon says, good, that's the spirit. Okay.
Hey, come back here.
Mephas went home already. I saw them off at the town's border. I wanted to play with them a little more.
Looking around for anybody else, the author or the GMing.
Alright, let's buy her. She's been with us long enough. Heavy mace. Increases her defense. Yeah, I'm gonna pass on it, actually. I don't want her defense going down. She's bad enough as it is. Light flail, though, is better. 51. Let's get her light flail. And chainmail, or ringmail, actually. Let's exchange the stuff. Luckily, there's a weapon dealer and his name is Hilt. It just fits. Alright, Light Flail. Attack from 43 to 51. Fine Shield, nothing better yet. Oh, we do have something better. That's right. Let's see if she can have that. Bizet Armor to Ringmail. Defense 40 to 46. That should help. Oh, I forgot. Magic Defense. Magic Attack. Avoidance. Oh, give her the Forest Cape. Look out. We go up by 20. Speed. Yeah, the Forest Cape definitely. Her avoidance needs to get up, and defense and all that stuff. We'll keep that on her. Fruit Witch. Oh, yeah, he gave us his stuff. He gave us the great sword, Douglas. Oh, wait, then he gave us the ring mail. We didn't have to buy ring mail for him. Let's sell the mace. Maybe we can give the Tonki to her. There's that armor we'll sell. Oh yeah, defense up two more. I keep buying this stuff and then getting it back and then selling it. Let me hold on to the great sword. Sell the raid boomerang. I'll keep the ringmail, great sword, and fine shield just in case. I'll see you in a couple seconds when we go around this side and talk to you. Talking mode. I hear Douglas went to Vault. He may meet her in Western Deuces, where Valkt is. I wonder what will happen. Meet who? Her? Says Avon? Yeah, exactly. She was also a disciple of Castle, the Saint of the Swords, just like Douglas. She's a crackerjack adventurer and the best in Deuces. People call her Sapphire Eyes. Wasn't Saffy, is it? She and Douglas go back a long time. I hope they won't get themselves into a fight. Well, that's interesting. I've done several jobs with Sapphire Eyes myself. She was such a quick draw, and I was captivated by her skills. It just makes me think of Saffy from the Swordswoman Saffy books. Chid has already gone out. A child is full of energy. By the way, it seems Douglas went to Valkt. I miss him. I thought you didn't like him very much. These humans are so confusing. Talk to the mayor again. Oh, Avon! I heard the Great Oracle Avarice was arrested. Words travel fast, says Avon. Has Douglas been here by any chance? Yes, he has. He said that he was transporting the Great Oracle to the Holy Capital. It's so Douglas, says Mile. He made the time to greet you, Mayor. Mayor says he is truly a dutiful man. I thank you for all your help. I would like to give this to you. It may help you along the way. Ooh, give us a whatever Arcanum 3. Really? Can we have it? Says Mile. Yes, by all means. Thank you so much. You are the saviors of New Boren. Wow, that's nice of him. Douglas has gone to the Holy Capital. We have tons of jobs we wanted to give him. Well, Silva has become a skilled adventurer. Perhaps he will be able to cover for Douglas for a while. I heard the poisonous air was caused by the great oracle at church. What kind of oracle is he? I'm glad he was caught. Well, I should cheer myself up. I'm going to open a store that's one of a kind. Please come by someday. I'll have my store ready by then. Ready by someday, huh? The thick fog and my gloomy feeling are all gone. Newborn is not newborn without these soothing breezes. Alright, let me go and catch some wild boars. Thank you for hunting wild boars and not Mifas. I didn't know Mifas was such a cute animal. Don't worry, if my husband ever comes back with Mifas again, I'll kick him out of the house. Is that a promise? Alright, north is Guia. We'll be heading there next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.